Hi, my name is Peter Kraker and I'm the founder of Open Knowledge Maps. Today, I'd like to talk to you about the importance of open access for discovery. Open access has many advantages. It increases the accessibility and reusability of scientific knowledge. But it also enables us to build better discovery systems. In the past, only a few search engines had access to the world's research output. This caused many problems, including low visibility and low reuse of scientific findings. Just compare how easy it is to get to general knowledge, for example via Wikipedia, versus the effort that you have to put in to get an overview of a scientific topic. Therefore, research is often needlessly duplicated and it doesn't reach the people that actually need it. But with open access, all of this is changing. Finally, we can all access scientific knowledge. We can, for example, mine the full text and extract semantic information from it. We can combine this information with metadata and open metrics to create truly innovative discovery tools. Open Knowledge Maps, for example, enables you to create visual overviews of research topics. To do so, we reuse the Open Discovery infrastructure that gives us access to more than 150 million scientific outputs. We can also display open access articles directly within the interface and offer additional capabilities for it, for example, the functionality to annotate the paper. Therefore, by publishing open access, you do not only make sure that your research can be read more widely, you also make sure that it is more visible. By following a few simple rules, such as the use of open licenses and persistent identifiers, you make sure that your research is part of the current and future discovery infrastructure. This means that your research can be found, read, and reused by people from all around the world.